Jutteverken Burmeister Wine Instructional Film. Fuel valve to all KGF engines, replacement and overhaul. This operation is also described in the instruction book, Volume 2, Maintenance Part 901-2 and 909-8. Before we commence the work, we must follow 5 safety measures, namely, stop the engine, block the start mechanism by closing the tap for the starting air, connect the turning gear, open the display cocks, close the oil supply tap. When these operations have been completed, we can then begin the replacement of the fuel valve. It is assumed that the following items are at hand: a normal tool kit, a replacement valve, which we have collected from the stores, cleaning material and grinding material in the form of carborundum 200. The special tools required are an extractor plus grinding and milling tools for the fuel valve. Commence dismantling by undoing the pipe connection for the return oil from the fuel valve. The high-pressure fuel pipes are removed between the distributor part and the valve. When the nuts are unscrewed, the spring housing can be removed from the studs. When the fuel valve is drawn out from the hole, it is quite possible that the 2 extractors will be needed. Clean the hole in the cylinder head thoroughly and inspect the valve seat very carefully. If it is pitted or defective in any way, it must be ground. Grinding is carried out with special tools. The guide is fitted to the handle first, and then the larger milling tool intended for the valve seat. The next grinding operation covers the sealing surface, and we select the smaller milling tool for this part of the job. The whole operation is completed by finely grinding with the grinding disc, a few drops of oil, and carborundum 200. After having cleaned the parts thoroughly, we can check if the seat is smooth and without defects. The 3 plastic plugs are removed from the replacement valve, which is then lubricated with heat-resistant Mollycoat grease. Place the replacement valve in the cylinder head. The spring housing is replaced and the nuts are then screwed onto the studs. Tighten the nuts alternately until the pressure washers are flush with the spring housing's upper face. The high pressure pipes and the fuel oil return pipes connections are refitted and the change is completed. Overhauling. It is important that the working area is clean for this type of work. A sheet of paper, a sheet of plastic foil, or something similar is an excellent thing to spread out over the workbench. The special tools required for overhauling a fuel valve are as follows: tools for the nozzle, 4 different grinding tools, Tommy bars, a normal tool kit, cleaning fluids such as kerosene or diesel oil, Vaseline or similar lubricant, and carborundum 500 grinding material complete the picture. The rubber ring under the valve housing is taken away. Tighten the valve in a vise. The union nuts are then removed with the help of the Tommy bars. It is now possible to lift the valve head up from the valve housing and to remove the pressure spindle, pressure washer, valve unit, and the nozzle. The nozzle hole is cleaned with the help of the special drills. This applies to both the center hole and the nozzle hole. The nozzle hole's dimension must be checked. The case for the nozzle tool also contains a so-called test gauge. If the test gauge can slide into any of the four nozzle holes, the nozzle must be exchanged for a new one. The O-rings in the valve head are removed and discarded. In order to stop grinding material from getting into the valve head when the mating surfaces are ground, the seat is filled with Vaseline or similar lubricant. The special tool shown here is used when grinding. The grinding medium is carborundum 500 and a few drops of oil. The pressure spindle's lower and upper seats are ground later with the same grinding material, but with another special tool. The valve unit's lower seat is ground. Note the tool guide, which is used. This is used to achieve a ground surface which is as perfect as possible. Finally, the valve housing's mating surfaces are ground as well. All the parts are washed in kerosene or diesel oil after they have been ground. They are then cleaned and dried with compressed air. New O-rings are fitted to the valve head. The valve housing's parts are assembled as we see here. Note the correct sequence and make sure that the pressure spindle is fitted the right way. The fuel nozzle is replaced first, then the valve unit, and then the pressure washer. The pressure spindle comes last with the spring downwards. The union nuts are replaced and tightened with the Tommy bars. Fit a new O-ring against the union nut. The valve must now be tested to see if it functions properly, so we fasten it to the test bench. In order to obtain perfect tightening of the valve, we simulate assembly in the cylinder head. This means that the valve housing is fitted with the spring housing under the nuts. It is important that the nuts are tightened alternately in order to achieve correct seal. The valve is connected to the test pump via the pressure pipe and then filled with fuel oil. The pressure is pumped up slowly in order to control the opening and closing functions. During the upstroke, oil runs out through the return hole. When the pressure has reached 1 megapascal or 10 kilopounds per square centimeter, the valve closes and the oil ceases to flow. Continue pumping up to 20 megapascal or 200 kilopounds per square centimeter, and note that when the pumping is stopped, the pressure drops slowly. When it reaches about 1 megapascal, that is to say 10 kilopounds per square centimeter, the return oil passage opens and the pressure quickly drops to zero. Screw a plug into the return hole and pump the pressure up to 20 megapascal again. Check that the oil does not leak out past the O-ring between the valve head and the valve housing. Otherwise, this means that the O-ring leaks. The nozzle will not leak if the overhaul operation has been correctly carried out. Remove the plug from the return oil hole and pump up the pressure to 25 megapascal. In other words, 250 kilopounds per square centimeter. If everything is as it should be, and if the holes in the nozzle are correctly aligned, the fuel oil will pass through the holes into the control plate's hole. If the valve has passed these tests we have done, we can assume that the valve is serviceable again. If it is going to be stored, all the openings are protected with plastic plugs, and the whole valve is greased with heat-resistant mollicoat grease or similar lubricant to avoid eventual rust attack during the storage time. ¶¶